Yeah, I would like to welcome you to our weekly trades. In the background, we can see here the S&P 500, and what is significant, especially when we look here on the left-hand side, that the last 7 days we had always a new all-time high. You can see this here with the blue dots. So after the breakout, S&P climbed higher every day, and especially today. We are 0.6% in profit, I think, before the long weekend in the US, where we have a holiday on Monday. Independence Day is on this Sunday, but on Monday all the markets are closed. I think it will go even a little bit higher in the next 2 hours, which are left for today. And we want to have a look, especially on some interesting stocks, which we saw this week what might be also an interesting investment opportunity for you. And if you don't want to miss any of these, please feel free to subscribe to our channel or to leave here a comment. The first one which I want to present you is OPTT. You can see on the right-hand side the chart with a really significant call volume today, more than 47,000 on the call side. And I also want to show you which call was specially traded today. It was call option on July the 17th with a strike price of $5. So it means at the end, the stock, or it's expected that the stock might jump another 80-90% to reach this target in the next 2 weeks. And if you consider that Monday is a holiday, then it's even only 9 trading days. But as we can see it here already at the beginning of the year, before options were even available for this stock, when there's a new trend, it can go easily up to even prices, what we saw here, $6-$7. So might be really an interesting stock for a short period of time for movement in the next week. Not only for option trading, also for small portfolios, can this be a very interesting position. On the other hand side, at the moment, like we discussed it before our short summer break, it's really hard to find good option volume on a long expiration day. At the moment, we can really see a lot of short-term position only on a weekly basis or even on a very short period of time. But still, there are a few options I would like to show you, and we can also see what might make sense, some interesting put options or maybe also interesting short positions. Here, for example, one ETF on the Chinese market with the symbol KWEB. And we are really close to break through this support line here with $66. I can see some bets for the next 2 weeks that it will fall down to $64. And I think most probably it's only, this is not on all Chinese stocks. This is especially for internet stocks on the Chinese market. But yesterday we saw also on some emerging markets some down movement. I think this was especially caused because the fear of coronavirus will have maybe a bigger impact or a longer impact on the emerging markets than other markets. What is connected to the vaccine or how fast people can be vaccinated there. And I think these markets might have a bigger fear for a down movement at the moment, but this is also something what we will see all in the next few months. Other than this, what can be also interesting, especially for the US market, is now we are coming to the third earnings season, which normally starts with all the big finance companies in the next few days. And then we will see if the S&P 500 can still move up to a new all-time highs, or if we really see a correction in the next few weeks. Another interesting short position, I think we spoke about this in one of our earlier videos, is TAL Education. We saw the stock was already here at $90 in the middle of February. Now the next target is, I think, $20 is the last, the lowest course for the lowest price for this year. And it really looks like it will also break through this $20 in the next few weeks. These are at the moment the bets that it will even go down to August to $17.50. And as you can see, we have really a high put volume, what's higher than on the other side, the call volume. But on the other hand side, we also see a really high implied volatility. The stock only today almost 10% in minus. That shows how volatile this stock is, and it makes it also a little bit more difficult to trade this, especially with options. Yeah, other than this, what was also one of the stocks we presented you earlier, I think a few weeks ago, in one of our videos, is Virgin Galactic. Virgin Galactic finally got approval by the NASA, by NASA, by NASA, to have the first flights in the space. And as we can see, this happened exactly here last week. Now, I think it's a little bit difficult on this high level to trade this stock, but still, I think a nice opportunity on days when it moves back a little bit, maybe also for a long-term position, because yeah, this next really important level is the $60, what's the yearly high from February. And as you maybe can remember from the last video, the most important thing was that this test flight, what was postponed in December because of some problems, happened a few weeks ago. Results are pretty good, and this caused at the end also the approval by NASA for the flights. And I think Virgin Galactic also very interesting stock for your portfolio. Yeah, what else we had from this week? Like I said, it was pretty slow, what's normal, and nothing special in summer, especially also when the market is not so volatile and we are having only prices near the all-time high with not that big movement. We had, for example, Discovery Incorporation, and here you can't see any big movement. This yeah, causes because of the big drop what we had at the end of March, where the price of Discovery Incorporation almost dropped 50% in 3 days. Now it find I think the stock found his bottom, and especially yesterday we had quite good call volume, almost triple the normal size, and bets are here going to $37.5 till August, but still a little bit far, I would say, but can be a very interesting stock, especially after this long down movement in the last few weeks. And like I said, the next earnings will be or will start in the next few weeks, and this might be also interesting when Discovery Incorporation announce the result of the last earnings. And the last stock for today was one from the oil and gas industry, Halliburton. Here it's interesting. On the one hand side, we had a really high call volume yesterday also almost triple the normal size. We have here this typical double high at $25, and the idea here, if it will go go above this level, we will really see a breakout, what can easily lead to new yearly highs, so 52-week highs. I think the bets what we mainly saw yesterday was on $28 till $28 till September. On the right-hand side, you can also see now the option and here the open interest, what increased significant yesterday after all these options were traded. So these are all the stocks from this week. I hope you will subscribe to our channel and leave a comment. I will be happy to welcome you next week again. Stay safe and see you soon. Bye-bye.